Hello and welcome to Music at the Monastery. I'm Father Jim Gardner, one of the friars here at the Franciscan Monastery of the Holy Land, and it's my great pleasure to welcome today Dr. Carl Schwartz, who is the Director of Music at All Hallows Episcopal Church in Edgewater, Maryland.
The themes of the program today are light, joy, and peace. The first piece in the program, the prelude in the classic style, was composed by Gordon Young, whose dates were 1919 to 1998, an American composer who specialized in writing accessible music for church choirs of good quality. And within his works are some very special gems. This is a joyous piece, happy and very engaging. It shows off the bright colors of the organ. In the last year of his life, Johannes Brahms wrote a set of chorale preludes, published posthumously, Opus 122. I've selected two from this set. O wie selig seid ihr doch, ihr Frommen, and that first line of the chorale translates, O how blessed are they whose toils are ended, who through death have unto God ascended. The second one I selected is based on the chorale Schmücke dich, O liebe Seele, deck thyself, my soul, with gladness, leave the gloomy haunts of sadness, come into the daylight splendor, there with joy thy praises render, unto him whose grace unbounded hath this wondrous banquet founded, high o'er all the heavens he reigneth, yet to dwell with thee he deigneth. The Fugue in G minor, BWV 578, composed by Johann Sebastian Bach, is a youthful work. It's a work, piece of music which I have engaged with for many years. And I've come to the conclusion that the subject of the fugue, which opens with the triad and closes with its retrograde, may allude to the Holy Trinity. That's only an opinion. It's not something which is cast in stone. It is a joyous and happy work, one of his most popular compositions, frequently played in transcriptions by other instruments. Another lovely Lutheran chorale, Liebster Jesu, wir sind hier, dearest Jesus, we are here, is here heard in a setting by the late 19th, early 20th century German composer Siegfried Kargellert, who lived from 1877 to 1933. Kargellert was, among many things, professor of harmony at the conservatory in Leipzig, Germany. Here, I think he has set the second stanza of the hymn with very colorful, dark, brooding harmonies. All our knowledge, sense, and sight lie in deepest darkness shrouded, till your spirit breaks our night with your beams of truth unclouded. You alone to God can win us. You must work all good within us. Dietrich Buxtehude, who was organist in Lübeck, Germany, lived from 1637 until 1707. His music is wondrous. The fugue in C, often referred to as a jig fugue, is especially remarkable in that it is a very lengthy and continuous work written in an era when organ compositions tended to be sectional, that is, divided up into shorter sections. It's often played because it's lively and dance-like. In this wonderful space, it takes on the quality of many ringing bells in the pedal entrances at the end sounds like large bells ringing. So it's an example of how the room can inform the effect of the musical composition, the Fugue in C by Dietrich Buxtehude. Herbert Howells, whose dates were 1892 to 1983, was an English composer of church music and other concert music. He wrote two sets of preludes based on and inspired by verses from the Psalms. Opus 32, number 2, is based on Psalm 37, verse 11. But the meek-spirited shall possess the earth, and shall be refreshed in the multitude of peace. It is a tone poem based on these words, and a lovely piece indeed. In the last year of his life, César Franck, noted French composer of German origin who lived from 1822 until 1890, composed three organ chorales, which are chorale paraphrases, basically large tone poems, fantasies. It's generally agreed that each one is a tone poem about one person of the Holy Trinity. The first chorale is God the Father, the second chorale is God the Son, and for this period of time where we're moving towards Pentecost, I'm playing chorale number 3 in A, which portrays the Holy Spirit. And I believe the music explains itself quite well. It's full of contrast, lyricism, fire, and just a mighty, mighty piece of music with a grand ending. César Franck's chorale number 3 in A.
Thank you very much to Dr. Carl Schwartz for this wonderful presentation. This is the final one for this current season, the 2021 season of Music at the Monastery. It gives me an opportunity to say thank you to all of you who have been so faithful in supporting this series, and also to Dr. Russ Weissman, who puts the series together as the artistic director, and of late as the one who does the production. All that production work. Thank you to everybody. God bless. Stay in touch.